Hey guys, Derek here with Reddit Cigar Reviews, back in the Mobile Cigar Lounge today. And today I have a really cool cigar, one that I've been looking for the longest time. And the only reason I have it is because I was lucky enough to meet Steve Saka, the CEO of Drew Estate recently, and he gave me this. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Velvet Rat. Alright guys, so this here is the Velvet Rat. I've been looking for this for the longest time, like I said, and I met up with Steve Saka a little while back, and he was kind enough to give me this and some other different cigars, also a Herrera Esteli, which was an awesome smoke in its own. But here, I wanted to do the Velvet Rat. Why? Because I just hit 1,000 subscribers, which is a milestone. And I'd like to thank all of you guys, all of my subscribers and friends that have really helped me out along the way and kept me going. I'd like to thank all my brothers over at Our Cigars on Reddit. You guys are seriously the best, and I would not be doing it.
Fuck.
As I was saying, I would not be here if it wasn't for you guys, so thank all of you. Alright, so the Velvet Rat here is a Nicaraguan cigar. It has a Connecticut Broadleaf High Mediums wrapper on here. It's a very smooth and delicious looking wrapper. A little toothy, very, very smooth and soft feel. It's a firm cigar. Alright, no soft spots anywhere. Okay, has a nice looking filler, nice looking pack here. And the filler's a Honduran and Nicaraguan. And the binder here is their pretty much usual Brazilian Matafina. It's a 6.25 by 46 Lonsdale. It's the same size as the Ratzilla, all right? So if you've had the Ratzilla, this is what you're gonna be looking at. It looks pretty much the same. It does have a darker wrapper, I've noticed. It looks a little bit darker than some of the other wrappers that are out there, like the Liga 9, around the same shade. Just a great looking smoke with a little tiny pigtail cap on there. All right. Let's get her snipped. Yeah, I forgot my tripod today, so that's why the camera fell. Cool. Cut beautifully. Has two caps on there. Nice and smooth cut. Let's get her toasted. Let's do a pre-light draw first. Very reminiscent of the Liga 9. With kind of like a nice chocolatey taste. A nice chocolatey coffee. This is going to be a good smoke, I can already tell. It's a heavy cigar. In your hands, it is a heavy, heavy smoke. It's not light. The pack feels very good. And it's already putting out quite a bit of smoke. All right. Here we go.
Oh, Lord Jesus, it's a fire.
This is really good. Very, very similar to the Liga 9. Just a little bit more on the lighter side. It already has this creaminess and a little bit of leather, a nice earthy tone, kind of a little bit of a woodiness, like a cedary tone coming through here. And it's putting off the smoke yet again, as always with the Drew Estate stuff. It has almost a feral flying pig taste to it. Kind of like just a whole bunch of flavors rummaging around in my mouth, and I'm trying to pinpoint one of them right now and I can't think of it. Almost like a licorice, like an earthy licorice. Medium bodied right now so far. I'm liking it. All right. Let's go ahead, get into the first third of the Velvet Rat, and I'll be right back. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Guys, I am back with the Velvet Rat with an update, and the update is awesome. The flavor is really bumped up. The body is just slightly more increased, so it's now kind of like a medium full in body. And just out of nowhere, this burst of a really smooth, not like in your face pepper started to arise along with a really smooth cocoa. And the cocoa is just like right in your face. It's like unmistakable. It's really good. Solid burn all the way down so far. Almost at the halfway point. I've been smoking this for about, I want to say 25 minutes. The ash, beautiful and white, spots of light gray, and it's very solid. It's been holding on for about an inch and a half, 2 inches at a time, and I've only had to tap it once because it got a little bit of a crack in the ash. I also did get a little tiny crack in the wrapper, but I think that's just because it's cold out and the temperature didn't like the cigar very much, so it was like, eh, whatever. Along with the pepper and the coffee and the cocoa, it has gotten sweeter, like a sugary sweetness, but not, yet again, not overpowering. This is, I want to say it's kind of like a more medium-bodied version of the Liga Privada number 9. It's very good, it's very tasty, very reminiscent of the Ratzilla and the Dirty Rat and all the other rats. It's just fantastic. You really get that long-lasting finish with these, and this one is no exception. One thing I noticed real quick, the band, let me show you the back here. What's missing? There's no stamp. It's a pre-release blend, and I'm not sure why that stamp is missing on the back. Doesn't have the Liga Privada, doesn't have the Unico stamp on there. I'm not sure why. Most likely because it is a pre-release, but hey, you can see it says might be hard to see, but up at the top there, pre-release blend, sample blend, pretty cool stuff. All right, let's get into the halfway point, see if anything else changes. I'll be right back. All right, guys, into the halfway point of the Velvet Rat, and it's remaining fairly consistent, although it is getting a little bit more flavorful. More flavors are starting to pop out. Definitely kind of a floral taste is coming through now, which is really interesting for me. I don't really get that taste in many cigars, but this one here is just kind of giving that to me for some reason. But I like it, and it's going well with the other flavors like the coffee and the chocolate. It's built up even more of an earthiness, and the pepper is kind of died down just a little bit, but not too much. It's still there, hanging around way in the back of the palate, which is really nice. Yeah, but so far, so good. I am really liking it at the halfway point. Probably the best part of the cigar. We'll see how the final third is, and I will be right back. All right, guys, finishing up on the Velvet Rat here. And it has been an excellent cigar. Solid burn all the way through, perfect draw with a little bit of resistance, and just an all-over excellent construction. Just no complaints whatsoever, except for one. I have one complaint, that this cigar is not a mile long.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Because I could sit here and smoke this for days. I really liked it a whole lot. Just great flavors throughout the whole thing. Very complex, very different flavors. Very woody, earthy, leathery, chocolatey, cocoa-y. Just all those flavors melding together in just this perfect medium-bodied smoke with a very long-lasting finish too, which is nice. This burned for about an hour and 45 minutes. It's getting a little hot, so I'm gonna go ahead and let it die. But yeah, just a great smoke, and I'm going to go ahead and give this one a 9 out of 10. And I'd like to thank again Mr. Steve Saka for this. Very kind of you, my friend, and I'm hoping to meet up with you again soon. Maybe have some cigar geeky talk. So yeah, guys, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in and watching and subscribing and supporting. It really means a lot to me, and now that I'm at 1,000 subscribers, I'm just blown away that you guys like the videos, which is pretty cool. So let's get to 2,000. Let's see what we can do. But yeah, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here, get my hair cut, see my girlfriend, whatnot. So yeah, anyway, guys, I'd like to thank you again for watching. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do. You won't be disappointed. And guys, again, thank you. And until next time, happy smoking.